According to Nansen and Dan, pension administration has been in existence since the colonial era, starting with the defined benefit schemes, which means retirees go home with their gratuity and pensions, which he said has proved difficult. He added that the system could not be sustained, as witnessed with a lot of pensioners roaming the streets of their state capitals and the federal capital territory.
A contributory pension makes provision for the fact that you can take your contributions once you are 50 years or if you retire at the age of 50. And no one is excluded from the scheme for the fact that, okay, you're old or you're small, you're young. The snag is most employees think that when a contributory scheme is put in place, they may not receive equitable pensions and gratuity, and which is not right.
Nansen then said, with over 12 trillion naira currently in the custody of pension administration, the new scheme remains the best.
Yes, here in the FCT Area Council Staff Pension Board, we'll be able to draw up strategies to manage this retirement system effectively. And we have been receiving the contributions optimally. The second thing is that you must draw up certain systems that will help you to work. The first system is a pension management system.
Making reference to the proposed Plateau Contributory Pension Scheme, which is at formation stage as the bill is before the State House of Assembly, the expert said it is a win-win situation for government and civil servants.
Leadership is key. If we say we need to pay pensioners this month, we should pay them. If we owe pensioners, we should have strategies to get funding to pay them. And in that case, there will be less agitation from pensioners and the system will work.
He commended the pension scheme initiated by Plateau State to pay off all backlog.
Those who are within the defined benefit scheme, they have to be patient because it's not easy to get funding in billions at the same time to pay pensioners. But what the state government is doing currently in trying to get a third-party investment company to pay liabilities and then recover through ISPO is commendable.
This is Roland Longs.